Hannah Olech has a degree in biology, but if you see her strolling around her alma mater, Clark University, it will most likely be in red velvet and not a white lab coat.
My 1938 red velvet evening gown. I really love the research and design phase and picking the fabric. I really like cutting it out. I like the sound that the scissors make. So I really like cutting it out, and I really like the hand sewing.
The 24-year-old Hudson native uses fabric and needle and thread to time travel, sewing historical costumes that date back as far as the 12th century.
So there are lots of subtle things where you can tell the social class of a garment. So I've trimmed this in gold, which in the period would have been made of actual cloth of gold. So what they did was they melted gold and they took very fine fibers and they ran it through. And then because gold is so soft, you can actually stitch with it.
You see, Hannah isn't just a seamstress, she's also an historian.
I love the connection that it helps you feel to the past. When you look at, they call it domestic history, so clothes, food, etiquette, those little everyday life things, it helps you feel that, well, the people who came before us are not hard to connect to. They weren't that different from us.
She also likes to wear what she sews, to stitch and take a step back in time.
I would be lying if I didn't say that I just like to dress up. I like the pretty dresses. I like the big skirts and the silks and the beading and the embroidery. I like to feel pretty. So I would be lying if I didn't say that that wasn't one of the things that I love about it.
Hannah hasn't always been handy with a needle and thread, but she has always had a flair for the dramatics.
I had a snakeskin trunk, and that was full of dress-up clothes of all different. I had like little cowboy outfits, and I had princess outfits, and I had fairy outfits, and I had all sorts of stuff. I started sewing about 5 years and change ago because I had it in my head that sewing must be really hard or people would still do it.
A college science major with a dorm room full of fabrics and dress forms, Hannah turned some heads, but she was on a mission.
Really, I wanted the costumes eventually because I wanted them so badly, but there was no way I was going to be able to afford them anytime soon.
Many hours and threads later, Hannah's costume dreams came true.
My dream dress has always been like an 1850s Victorian, like off-the-shoulder evening gown on a huge steel crinoline. I love the big, Cinderella's my favorite. I love the big like Cinderella style ball gowns. That's what I wanted. Like that was the dream, the goal. Currently, I have things dating from the 12th century to the 1890s, but the range I'm interested in goes from the 10th century to World War I. So this is made of silk du peony, and it's interlined with buckram, which is cotton fabric stiffened with glue to give it some support, because this is from a period where there are no boned like support garments yet, no corset type garments. Fabric will be very inspiring. I'll scroll through fabric online. I'll go to a in-person fabric store and I'll touch them, I'll feel them. And that's where the inspiration starts. And then I'll get a picture in my head of what I think and I'll draw it in pencil. So this will be an 1880s bustle period winter outfit. This is where my designs come to exist on paper. I'll have an idea and it comes here to be drawn. So each one has the time period it's for and the time, so like an evening gown or like a day dress. And then each one also has a list of what pieces will need to go into it.
Designed, researched, sketched, and sewn, the costumes are a labor of love.
Generally, I have enough knowledge of the periods to know what I can mix and match to create something original and still be appropriate to something that could have existed. We're in the 18th century. This is called a robe à la Turque. This thing is called a fichu, so it's tucked in to fill in the neckline of the gown. Not for modesty, they weren't actually particularly modest, but to protect your skin from the sun, no sunscreen.
The Clark grad reserves nearly half of her Worcester apartment for her costumes, accessories, and sewing supplies.
So I keep big and bulky headpieces up here. So this is an 1850s bonnet.
Hannah says her historic masterpieces are just a hobby, and that her future career is with microscopes, not muslin. She wants to get her PhD in infectious diseases.
I really don't want to make professionally for other people, because then it's a job. Then it's got deadlines. Pre-COVID, I would attend the occasional costume ball or Renaissance fair. I hope to start doing that again. And sometimes I just wear them around the house because I put a lot of time into them and they fit me, so I might as well wear them.
Hannah has more than enough fabric and sketches to keep her busy designing, researching, sketching, and sewing, because time travel can be addicting.
So I'll finish it, the last one, and I'll go, okay, now what? And then like there's just like a 2-second pause before I jump into the next one.